Today I am going to prime and hopefully, if I can do it, the white on the belt. So belt is hanging, I got my primer, I got my white.
And bit of bad luck.
As I was painting this piece, because I'm using this stand and it's windy as Chicago in New Jersey every single day, this piece hit the deck and I had to grab it and it was covered, completely covered in grass. So you can see fingerprints and marks and everything where I was pulling grass off. And now I'm trying to cover those spots back up again, and this part basically got all screwed up. And this part didn't. So then what I had to do is, and then I sanded it a little bit to try to get some of the scuffs out, and that made it worse. So then I had to kind of screw up this side on purpose. I don't know if you can see any areas, maybe on the other side because of where the sun is, but I then had to make some scuff marks on this side so that they matched. Now, good news is weathering, right? Weathering. But I'm angry. So I'm painting again. Always quick video. Last night I worked pretty late, so it's morning, I'm a little more rested. This is my chest armor. The heck is up there? No, it's dust. I'm sanding. Very, very happy with the marks, the paint, the size of everything. It's weird. The markings that are on the CRL and the markings that are in the picture are completely different. This says, whatever size it says in the CRL, I don't remember. But then when you look at the picture in the movie, it is, like, this square is really tiny and this space is bigger. So it's almost like the reverse of this. But this is what the CRL asked for, so my GML said we gotta go with the CRL. And I'm happy with the look. Overall, I think it's a good look. Got the straps back in. I actually started weathering the straps yesterday. That's why they look a little dirtier than the armor. You can see the back. On the CRL, he has almost taken all of his white off, or blue off in the back. I tend to think if this was real, really blue armor, blue paint, that most of it would still stay blue. And I think it looks good. I also don't want to be exactly like him. The only question I'm going to have to ask on the boards is, in the CRL, these four circles are painted black, and it makes no mention of them being painted black. So I think he just did that as per his preference. I kind of like the black look. I think they should be black. And obviously when I weather, they will get black in here inside of these vents. So I'm going to post a question on the boards and see what people say, but pretty sure that they're going to say I can do either or. Up here, this is where I had accidentally cut out this section. And you can see slight areas where the putty still was. If I get really close, you can see it. But when I weather, hopefully I can hide some of that. I might put some marks to break up the lines. But I think overall that's going to be okay. I don't think anybody really notices that unless they're looking for it. And then today, I was doing my belt. Let me get this out of the way. I'm probably going to weather this today. So today I decided to do the belt, and I had it hanging out. New Jersey is a very windy state for some reason. So I had it hanging in two pieces, and half of it fell off. And it fell in the grass, and there was grass everywhere. And I started panicking and pulling grass off and getting fingerprints everywhere. So if I zoom, you can probably see marks of, see definitely up in this corner there. Trying to see if I see any other places. I was able to actually clean up a bunch of it. Yeah, it's overall not too bad. I guess I did a pretty good job cleaning up, but there was grass everywhere. So now the belt is all white in one piece. Got my boxes in the back. This is where it aligns. And when I weather, you know, it'll get inside there. Hopefully hide that seam a little bit better. That's where it connects. You can see the snaps. The only thing I'm super unhappy about, you can see I put those things on. Here I gotta sand a little bit more. Try to get rid of this top seam. You can still see that a little bit. This is gonna get hidden under the TD, so you're not gonna see that at all, but I do wanna kinda just clean that up a little bit. These you shouldn't see, and again with weathering, if I break up the line with a mark or something, it should be okay here, but the TD goes there. When I put the boxes on, oh, there's an ant. I didn't, like, when I made my holes, right, so I made holes here and here, and then I go to make holes on the other side, and I kind of eyeballed it. So what I didn't realize is you can see that this box is a little wonky. It's a little angled. You can see the distance at the top and the bottom here especially. So I would have liked if that was parallel. I don't think it's a disqualifying factor. Because that would really piss me off. But I think we're okay. Little groove there. I was able to fill all those gaps. I had huge gaps in here with putty. And again, with weathering, it'll close it up even better. So, there's my belt. Kind of start to imagine things all fitting together. And my TD. Here is been painted white, and the caps are over there. So everything's coming together.